This is where some new technologies come in and enable us to do some really exciting things, okay? So the strategy is called DNA metabarcoding, and I'll explain what that means. So an animal dung, piece of animal dung, has a lot of undigested plant cells in it. Those plant cells contain, obviously, DNA. And specifically, we sequence a short region of DNA that's called a DNA barcode. And we can then match that plant DNA barcode to a plant species from our reference library, right? Obviously, what we need to make this work is a good reference library, right? That thing that was scrolling along the right side of the screen is a library, and we need to have a good one for this to work. So how do we do that? Well, we start by collecting a live plant from the field. We press it into a voucher specimen. We take that to the Smithsonian or the National Museums of Kenya or another museum that's willing to take it. And whether or not, incidentally, a museum is willing to take your specimen depends on how good a specimen it is. They're very picky. And so once we've got this, we can sequence the DNA, the chloroplast DNA of that same plant. And then we take that sequence and we add it to a growing online database, right? There's a community of people like us who are really interested in this stuff and have developed a repository, online repository, and you can search it, right? So when you, let's say I find my herbivore has been eating plant species X, well, fortunately, somebody in Zambia DNA barcoded that same plant species X. So I can use that to match my sample. So increasingly, right, this is a resource available to the whole community. Now, how do we get samples? You can go pick a sample up off the ground, and we do that, right? We make sure to pick samples that aren't touching anything else that might contaminate it, and we use gloves, and we use bags, and we do some additional post-processing steps to make sure that the sample is clean. But we can also do it a slightly more direct way, and so this is imagery taken this summer, and what we're doing here is getting ready to dart a kudu. There went the dart with a little pink tail on it. And we immobilize that female kudu and put a GPS collar on her that will give us an hourly fix. Over the course of the next year, we know exactly where that kudu's been. I could take you next break online and show you where this kudu was yesterday, because it's a satellite collar uploads, and we can download it from here. All right. So now we know where this animal is going. And therefore, we have a sense for what plant species are available to it, right? What it could potentially be eating. And when we have the animal anesthetized anyway, we take the opportunity to collect the first of what we hope will ultimately be a series of fecal samples from this individual so that we can know what it was eating the day before it had the misfortune of, that's why we wear gloves, of being darted and having this funny necklace put onto it, and you know it probably it goes back and tells its friends that something crazy just happened to it. You guys will never believe what just happened to me. But they you know, we can, this is a reversible anesthetic, and so we just put in the antagonist, and the animal jumps up and runs off. It's just fine, a little bit wobbly at first, but totally no harm done. Okay.